AZD.
This one's dedicated to everyone who loves someone.
Be the best and fuck the rest.
Just African the one rock star.
Let's get it.
West Media.
What's up, everybody? It's AZD. Hey, sexy lady. It was nice to know you. Move on. Oh. Hey, sexy lady. This is an adult channel, everybody. If you're going to watch with children, make sure you guide them through it. You're responsible for your own condition while watching my show. This is all being done under the banner of entertainment. Like you're going to a great movie or reading a great book. Rated X, rated R. Everything will be said and done to deliver the message. And finally, let the world know Arash D-Bazaar, known as AZD, is back. Enjoy the song. Hey, sexy lady. It was nice to know you. Let's get started again. Welcome, everybody. Excited to do this video blog on the 15th of February, 2021. St. Valentine's Day is done. Probably had a shitty one. All good, okay? No problem. Today, we're going to talk about a very important subject. And I decided I'll be teaching a little bit more on these videos. And that's the subject of communication. Well, now, this is not something that could be talked about in 15 minutes or 20 minutes or 20 days. 20 years, maybe, we could spend talking about this thing. I became incredibly fascinated with the subject of communication back in time when I read something that made me realize, it was a few points that I had read, okay? First of all, hold on a second. I would love to get to this comment live. I should do a video where I just go over these YouTube comments, okay? Let me show you something, everybody. Go get your lean on, shorty, bring it back. Ah, I got one last night. It was a new person. Adam Embler from YouTube. I hope you're watching, little fanboy. He quotes, shout out L. Ron Hubbard, ! Ha 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 ha, this fucking guy, he's talking about me, he's watching my show, commenting on my video. This fucking guy is an undercover Scientologist. Would I be undercover if I was shouting out L. Ron Hubbard, you stupid motherfucker? And I'm not a Scientologist, but I was one before, you dumb motherfucker. Hope you all have taken your stress test. Obviously you have, because you know what the fuck you're talking about. And watch out for his thetan. You mean thetan. You see, you have a few words and you're just a clown. And I'm not an undercover anything. You're an undercover faggot is what you are, first of all. But let me explain something to you. Not once in my life have I ever flinched from shouting out a person's name who helped me and gave me true knowledge. And L. Ron Hubbard has completely altered my life, and his writings are valid as fuck. You understand? And any ignorant person who would try to steer people away by a hateful comment like that literally has no reason to be alive right now. Okay? And so I just want you to know, you literally just put yourself in that category in karmic debt, it's called. That you literally just fucked yourself. But you're already fucked. You know that. That's why you comment like that, okay? I have no problem telling you who or where the information comes from. Because truth is truth, okay? If it's spoken from the lips of a child, or spoken from the lips of a homeless person, or spoken from the lips of a king, or a bird, or a cow, okay? When truth is there, we all must listen to it. We all must acknowledge and move forward with it, because that's the only thing that saves mankind. And anybody who tries to make you run away from truth and knowledge, that person is an evil human being, okay? So listen, you dumb motherfucker. Yes, L. Ron Hubbard. Yes, I studied it. Yes, I was a Scientologist. And I still think he's the motherfucking man, okay? I also said many other words in there. I also said many other teachers in there. And the fact that you zero in on that shows your evil little motherfucking ass, okay? Now, the beautiful part of it is, you don't exist besides on my channel in relation to me. But you yourself don't have any identity. You see that? And I'm AZ motherfucking D. Ask your mama about it. She would know. Now, moving forward, we're going to talk about exactly what I just did. Communication. You see, when you can communicate, there's literally what nothing anybody could say or do to throw you off your balance. And being thrown off balance is literally what people would try to do with you in business negotiations. That's what that is. In warfare, in any kind of relationship upset, in any kind of situation where somebody is coming at you in a negative way, what they're trying to do is make you lose balance, you could say. One way is they're trying to make you destabilized. You're stable, you're going to destabilize you. And you have to learn how to communicate. But more than that, I know a lot of great men, who nobody would know they were that great prior to meeting me because they didn't know how to communicate their greatness. And instead, they were communicating a bunch of creepy shit to the world because where were their role models? Right? Who were the men around us growing up who taught us how to communicate? Well, we know that television was a lie, right? We know that they were manipulating that, right? We became more educated when YouTube came around. YouTube educated many of us, honestly, and it still does. Now they're censoring in here and there or whatever, but we began to take control of what we wanted to watch, who we wanted to learn from, and people like myself who had some knowledge in the world began to put their knowledge out, right? One of those key ingredients in knowledge is the communication, okay? And communication, I believe, is the most important thing. So what I was going to say is I came across certain writings. One of them was from L. Ron Hubbard, of course. The other one was from Tony Robbins in his first book, Awaken the Giant Within. I was very young. He said a sentence, or he said a paragraph, if I could recall it. This is like, we're talking about 20 years ago that I read this, okay? Something about The world moved from a something age to an information age, and it was going to move to a communications age. I mean, he said this a long time ago, man. And he was saying that the information age one day would come to an end, which is everybody could access all information. Welcome to today. Tony Robbins had said that in his first book, or his first book I read from him. It was one paragraph in the very beginning, actually. And he said eventually what's going to matter is going to be the people who could communicate the information. Because there was a time where it was like the Cold War. I'm a little older than you probably. That was even before my time, right? But I knew about it. It was when information, spy information, was such a big deal. Now everything is hacked. Everybody has access to information across the world. But what's needed is who can discern the truth from the false and communicate it. Welcome to the age of the communicator, age of Aquarius, okay? And we're literally in it right now. So now is the time for everyone to recognize something I recognized a long time ago, that he who could communicate has the entire world in the palm of his hands. Mankind is a creature that has learned to communicate, and this is what has given us an advantage over every other creature. We have language, and so we can use it to study our past, to plan the future, to strategize, right? And if we were going to come across a more modern civilization, like from space somewhere, I'm sure they wouldn't be coming over here and saying ooga, ooga, go, go, go to each other. They would have a more modern language. They'd have a higher level of mathematics that would help them bend time and space the way they do to arrive from light years away. Like, we would know that they'd be more intelligent, and more intelligence would mean they're better communicators. Most likely, they wouldn't be using a different kind of a language that had more specific terms. Those terms would be describing things that you and I are not even aware of, right? Like if you and I go and we go 700 years ago or 1,000 years ago and begin to talk to them about today, they're not going to be aware of half the shit that's going on, right? So we're going to seem like, what the fuck? What are you saying? So those people or those beings that be able to span the universe and come to Earth and leave, right, would have to be more advanced than us in technology, and technology and the mind or intelligence are 100% related, right? And how do we know somebody is intelligent? Like, how do we know, or how do you know, how can you tell that I'm smart by the way I speak? Those are the facts of it, right? I can look like this, I can look another way, I can look 1,000 ways, I could have black skin, white skin, orange skin, it don't make a difference, okay? What matters is when I speak, it's obvious the way that I put the sentences together, what I know, how I can say the things that I say. And just so you know, right there, I just censored three words. Okay? There's a reason for that. Because you have to be able to communicate at a level that people can understand. Not that if I said delineate, you wouldn't understand it, but many people wouldn't understand it. Do you get the difference? And these videos are for everyone to watch. Right? There's a time and place to use big words and big vocabulary. And when you use that at the wrong time, you fuck up. Okay? And there's a right time to say fuck up. And there's a wrong time to say fuck up. You see? So communication has all these rules that we all know. Right? And many, many rules that we don't know that we have to study. But the first most important thing for me is, if you're a good person, people don't know that about you half the time. You may act nice, but no one trusts a nice guy anyways. Okay? It's not about being nice. It's about learning to communicate what's inside of you so that what's inside of you can come outside of you and the world can know about it. So maybe you're a very kind human being. Maybe you're very creative. Maybe you have a lot of genius inside of you. Whatever the hell is going on. Maybe you can help. Maybe you're brave. Who knows what the fuck you got going on, right? But the moment you begin to speak, you shut down. You don't know what to say. You feel stupid. You know, they say that the number one fear of mankind still is public speaking. I don't get that. But I don't have that. So it would be like for me, what is my fear? Spiders. Okay, let's say spiders. It's not, but let's say spiders. If I was afraid of spiders, then I would be like, I don't get how people are not afraid of spiders. So I'm not afraid of communicating. As you can see, it's very easy for me. For that reason, I teach it. So think about what has been your life like growing up, right? And who have been the people you've seen communicate, right? Whoever was around you, you've learned to communicate by observing those monkeys. And most of the time, there were monkeys, right? They could have even had PhDs here and there. But when it came to communicating with their own family, when it came to communicating with the world, they probably weren't the smoothest or the best, right? Communication also involves knowing how to communicate when you are in a certain emotional tone. Now listen, this is a big deal. For example, have you ever thought about it that when you're in anger, right? Everybody gets angry at some point in their day or in their life or in their week or sometime. Have you ever known that when you're angry, you should follow certain rules of communication if you don't want to upset your life any further? You know, as I say that, you know how true that is, right? There are anything said in anger, you're going to regret. Truly, you're going to regret it afterwards, okay? If you're not old enough to know that, you will know that one day. So there's a way to communicate when one is in certain emotional tones. For example, here's another law of communication. So let me give you one. Anger, shut your mouth. Video. What is the lion's den? This is a group that I teach the beauty and the art of what I call the beast, which is what I am and I've always been. It's my fulfillment to Manu, my teacher, and the application of what he said to me. It's only $97 a month. You sign up at riseapart.com. Every single day we meet, I change your life. I can't tell you much more. It is the program you have to be on. It's for men only. I will completely alter your existence. I'm the first example of it. If you know me, you need to be in the lion's den. I have changed so many lives so fast, you have no idea. Do yourself a favor, because you're $97 a month, I can shit that out any second. But you need me, and you need this art. It's not for everyone, but those who know, I'm about to change the entire course of your destiny. Be the best, fuck the rest. Okay? Don't say anything negative. Just don't. I know you want to blame somebody. Not when you want to tell someone they're bad. Stop. Anger is reserved for the enemy. And even then, you have to be very strategic when you use it. But, so anger is like, it doesn't really work very good for anybody. Okay? It works for you to use against your enemy. Meaning, make them angry. Make other people angry. Oh, you got them at that point. Next. What about when you feel a sense of love or inspiration? Are there rules to follow? Yeah, there is. There really is. Okay? So let me give you one to the men. Men, when you meet a beautiful woman, this strikes, oh my God, and you want to give her everything. That's the time to not do that. Pull back a little bit, okay? You're about to destroy your communication line with her. You're giving too much too fast. Yes, you feel it, right? And right here, you have to use your intelligence and learn to communicate and be around beautiful women enough so that the experience shows you that is not the time to say that. There are ways and things you can say during that time, but it's not to just throw all that emotion that just phew, nature gave you out into her face. What about a woman? Are there ways to communicate when you're feeling insecure and doubtful about yourself? Absolutely. Every time you've done that wrong and been with your man, you've caused an unnecessary fight. So these things are communications during certain emotions. That stands. How about communicating to elder people or like older people? Not elderly necessarily. There's communicating to the elderly. There's communicating to older people. Communicating to your own generation of people. Communicating to a younger generation. And then communicating to children. They are all different. Every single one is different. If you violate one, you make a big mistake. You should never communicate to a child the way you communicate to your peers, the people on your level. And you should never communicate to anyone like a child if they're not a child. Doesn't that piss you off? When people violate that, okay, class, sit down and we're going to do it. It's high school. A lot of teachers fuck that up, right? And what about talking to the elderly? Elderly, yes, you need to slow down. Okay, you need to soften your voice. They're elderly. What about to people older than you? Yes, you should always put a little bit of respect in your voice. Put a respect on that. Okay, a little respect on your voice. Even when you're in an argument with them. Because if you follow these rules, then the environment will become in your favor. And that's a good communicator. A good communicator is one, when they communicate, they don't violate the environment. And so an art of communication, an art of war is, you violate the environment, you have fuck up. You want to know a great example? Go through my YouTube. You'll find one or two people commenting negatively. They're violating the environment. They're watching a very positive video blog. They're watching somebody that other people care about. Other people value very, very much, actually. And they are putting something negative on there, right? So if they were in a room, they'd get their ass kicked, right? And that's why in a room, everybody would just shake my fucking hand and say, it's a pleasure to meet you, right? These people, they're violating the environment. Now, if they were on a channel that there was like 100 negative comments and there were the 101 negative comment, they'd be all right. But that's not what's going on, right? So you can see that it takes social intelligence to communicate. And that's what it is. And that's why women are attracted to men who could communicate. Because it says this man is socially intelligent, socially superior. He can make shit happen. He doesn't have to have the biggest muscles or be jump the highest or be the tallest. What he has is something even greater. He has the ability to communicate and get everybody aligned, get everybody on the team. Right? One person by themselves living in the jungle versus six people in the jungle. Six men versus one man. The one man doesn't stand a chance, okay? Because out of the six, every one of them will be able to take on an activity that they're better at, they're better equipped for, better designed for. So communication literally just runs your life, okay? How about communicating to your children? You know, there's a code for that. There's a way you should communicate to your children. What about the way you communicate to other people's children? Yes, totally different. What about strangers? How does one communicate with strangers? What about if you're a woman and you don't know a man and a man approaches you? What's the best way to shut him off, to tell him to get away from you so that you're safe? There's a way to do that. Okay? All of these things. Okay, we just said communication. Now we began to break it down. We could go more and more and more and more and more and more. How are you supposed to communicate to somebody when they just keep talking and talking and talking? You want them to shut up so you can get a word in there. There's ways to do that. How important is it that you're comfortable when you communicate? What about your emotions? Can other people feel your emotions when you're communicating? Is it important? What about your facial gestures? What about the sound of your voice? What about your rhythm? Will it make any difference if you speak in a different rhythm? When people listen, do they have a different sensation when you're speaking on a different rhythm? Of course, I did it like that. You go, well, why doesn't he do it like that? It's so much more pleasant. Because I got to get all this information out as soon as possible. That's why, okay? All right, we just... Bop, 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 bop. All right, so what do you do? First of all, I have a men's program. It's called the Lion's Den. We're going to meet today at 10 a.m., which is in 1 hour and 7 minutes. 10 a.m., I'm going to teach for 2 hours today, okay? It's only $97, which comes down to $3.24 a day, okay? Now, last night, again, two more people signed up. The day before, two more people signed up, but two people had dropped earlier on. So when they're canceled, the automatic payment doesn't go through, then we count them not minus, right? But two more people signed up today without any drops, so the count is now 112. Keep counting it, hater. Let's see where we go. It's $97 a month. We're going to get together, myself, and a lot of masters. You know, we had an 18-year-old amongst us yesterday who went to this to get three or four cavities filled. And he decided that he was going to use his willpower and not use anesthesia. And he did. And you know how he decided that? Because of the routine we have called the beasting routine. And he raised his hand. He said, I have a win. I want to share my success. And he said that. And we were all floored. And you know what I did next? I gave him the boot camp that I have at the end of the month, which I do every month. This one's called Tribal Council. I give it to him for free. That's a $2,000 product. Okay? Not because I just made it $2,000. Because motherfucker, many people pay $2,000 to show up for it. Okay? So he got it for free. And that's how we do it. We're among some great men every day. And I can't wait to show up. It's literally my favorite thing to do all day is to do that class. Okay? So that's, you get that at arajzepar.com. Araj, Z-E-P-A-R.com. Next, there's Instagram. You go to AZDIMC408. That's the numbers, 408. NorCal, like Northern California. AZDIMC408, NorCal. Okay, on Instagram, communicate. We'll communicate back to you. And also, that's where you get to see everybody. Who is IMC Nation? Who are the fighting monks? Who are these men that I'm talking about? Am I just blowing hot air? Or can you click their profiles and go learn something from them and see who they are and what they do? I bet you can. Prove me wrong. Also, you're going to see a lot of beautiful women there. And these women are protected. And you can test it. You can test it. Okay? Try to harass one of them and see what happens. You see how it goes? You're going to have a mob of men on your ass. All right? And that's how it works. We protect our people. And that's the lesson everyone should learn, okay? If you're just one person, you and your significant other, but you can't even stand each other and you lie to each other every day, okay? You guys are not together. You're an enemy to each other, okay? It starts with a man who leads a woman who believes in him. Then that man and that woman create something together, whether it's a child or a product or something worth going into society. Even your child is supposed to be a contribution to life, not a leech-sucking fucking animal. You together create something greater than each of you singly. You put it out into the world. That attracts attention from others. As they come forward, you start to create your tribe. You become the tribal leader. As your tribe grows, in your tribe, there will be people who can lead their own tribe. And you push them out. Not because you're insecure. You're not. You're very secure. You push them out. Because you know that their connection will never be severed. And they go out and they create their own tribes, and your tribe becomes even bigger. That's the United States of America. These are all separate states that united under one and became America. Think about how powerful that is. And that's why you go from one state to the other. They have their own laws. They have their own rules, right? There's the federal government. There's the local government. You get how this thing works? It's a code of law. And we can do that in our lives. And we do. I mean, I do it in my life, right? That's what IMC Nation is. Right? It consists of greatest men that I've met who have been able to lead other men or show the potential to lead other men and women. And we come together and we meet at the Lion's Den. And we meet once a month for some sort of a boot camp or beast camp, or we figure it out. But we meet because there's a lot of knowledge that keeps coming that needs to be pushed forward. Okay? It's been a long video blog, but what's it all about? Communication. And I know I didn't say much about to the ladies, but the point is, if you're a woman, you are looking for a man that you could admire, look up to, and so he can lead you and guide you. Hey, that's my advice, lady. Any other advice I give you, I'm just putting a band-aid on some shit that does not gonna fucking heal. You only have one saving grace. The woman's one saving grace is a powerful man who's a hero. Prove me wrong. Prove me wrong if you can. You can't. That's the whole point. You know why? Because God's on my side. Otherwise, he would have just made woman, or he would have just made man. And if someone says, well, what about a man? A man needs a woman so he can grow to his potential. Yes. A man who's never loved a woman, who's never had his heart broken, a man who's never taken responsibility for a woman or a child another, he still hasn't started his growth. He's still puberty. All right? Be the best. Fuck the rest. IMC Nation.